Welcome back to our three-part video tutorial on how to capture using your iPhone. In this video, we'll be customizing the Matterport model that we previously captured. Links to the other two videos are available in the description below, as well as up here in the corner. In this video, I want to talk about Mattertags, adding labels to your model, sharing your model, things like that. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing you're going to want to do is jump over to the Details tab over here to see the details of the model. Now, you'll notice that the model name that I gave it when I first captured the model is right up here, as well as the address that was captured is over here. Now, this is really important because I know a lot of people are very concerned with privacy. If you don't want the address to appear in the final model, just go ahead and change that to city, state, or you can also use the none option. Don't forget that you need to save this, and then you can come back to the media tab and we can begin our editing. Our model has been processed, and this model, because it's only two scan positions, really didn't take very long at all. First thing we want to do is just go ahead and hit the play button here to load the model. And once we're loaded, we can just have a quick look at it before we begin our edit. So this looks really good. I can move between the two different positions using either the keyboard or the mouse. And now I just want to hit the pencil icon over here to begin editing. Now, even though my model is only one room, your model may have more rooms. So you might want to use the labels feature. And to do that, you just go ahead and tap the labels tool over here in the toolbar and choose add. Now, as soon as we add, we'll get to the floor plan view because this is the best view to look at when adding labels. Also, when visitors are viewing your model, they will have to go to the floor plan view in order to see the labels you've created. So I'll just go ahead and click anywhere on the 3D mesh and just type in my label. And there's no limit to the number of labels that you can add. Now let's go ahead and create some matter tags. To do that, I'll just press the matter tag tool right over here. And I don't want to do this in the floor plan view, so I can either go to the inside view just by clicking anywhere or by choosing the dollhouse view in the bottom left corner. So let's go ahead and set our first matter tag. I'll press the add button up here. And then when I bring my cursor back into the model, you see that a matter tag comes along with the cursor and I can place it anywhere there is actually 3D mesh. So I'll just go ahead and place it over here, put in my matter tag. I can add a description, I can add a video, embed images, things like that, whatever I want to do to really enhance this model and give it as much information as possible for the visitors. So in this case, I'll hit done and I'll go ahead and add another matter tag. Hit done there. Okay, so now let's say I've got everything that I want tagged up is tagged up. Again, as I said before, you can embed videos from YouTube, images that are online, and just about anything you really want to personalize this and really make it your own. Now let's go ahead and create some measurements. You can do this for your visitors, so that way when they press the measurements tool, they'll already see the measurements that you took for them. So I'll go ahead and press the measurements tool icon. It looks like a little ruler over here, again in the toolbar, and press add. Now, depending on what it is that I want to measure, it might be easier to just click once to set a start point and then move over to set an end point somewhere. Or it may also be easier to just double click. So if I want the floor to ceiling height, I can just hit add. Let's go up here to the ceiling and just double click, press the check mark. And you can see that I have a perfectly vertical line going from floor to ceiling with that double click. So that makes it really easy to draw a line that is perfectly perpendicular to the surface on which you initiate the measurement just by double clicking. So now we've created some labels, we've created some matter tags, and I've taken some measurements. I encourage you to look through the other tools that are in this tool palette in order to discover more things that you can do with your model. But for now, I want to take you to a section over here that says photos. And what this is are actually pre-captured photos that the system generates as the model is being processed. You have a couple of photos that are pre-generated as well as a couple of teaser videos. And these are really, really great just to get you started in order to have something to share on social media very quickly without having really done anything at all in the model. Once you're done labeling and matter tagging the model so it's just as you want it to be, You can go back up into the Showcase tab over here. Don't forget to press Publish. That way, all the changes and additions that you've made are going to be public for other people to view. Once it has been published, you can go into the padlock icon right up here to unlock the space, confirm, and then press the share arrow to get your share link. All I have to do at this point is press the copy button over here. I'll have copied the share link and I can share that on any social media that I want. Last thing that I wanted to point out is the allow social sharing field down here, and mine is set to the default, which is enabled. But if in bold, yours happens to say disabled, you can go into the enable button right here to enable it. And that will allow your visitors access to this share button down here that they'll be able to press and copy the link or directly link to the model via any of these social media platforms. And that is really all there is to it. It's quite simple. There's not much involved in editing and polishing up your model to truly make it your own. And like I said before, this is really, really a great memory of the space that you have as it is right now. So adding these matter tags and labels to your model will only further enhance that effect and really make the model something a lot more personal to you. So get creative with it. Capture your space. Edit it any way you like by adding matter tags and labels, embed videos, making it so much more impactful and interesting for your visitors. And then finally, share your new 3D model with everyone you know.